Hello class, in previous lecture we saw that for voltage regulator using Zener diode has low frequency and circuit is useful for small input voltage and load current. Now we start with transistorized regulator. The block diagram of transistorized regulator consists of main component, that is transistor. Series pass transistor is present in the block diagram, which is power transistor. And in case of error amplifier, the one more transistor is present, and at the output, the potential divider arrangement R1 and R2 is present. Now we see the construction of the circuit diagram, which is given. Series pass transistor, that is transistor Q2, it is common emitter amplifier here. Now, error amplifier consists of transistor Q1, which gives negative feedback to the circuit. R1-R2 combination is the potential divider arrangement, which is shown in circuit diagram. It provides ample voltage. Arrangement takes ample voltage from the output. Means that due to this potential divider arrangement, the feedback voltage it is given to the base of the transistor Q1. Now here Zener diode is used to provide reference voltage VF to the circuit. Now RS is the series resistance which is connected to the Zener, which keeps the Zener voltage constant. R3 is the collector resistance of transistor of error amplifier. Now we see the operation of the previous circuit. Now in circuit diagram we see that the input voltage is the unregulated DC voltage, which is the input of the voltage regulator. And the function of this circuit is the regulator circuit, which maintains the constant output voltage despite of variation in load or input voltage. Now let us see the case first. When output voltage increases, as the output voltage increases, due to this, the voltage across resistance R2 increases, which provides more feedback voltage to the base of transistor Q1. It is error amplifier. Now, which produces a large collector current of Q1. We know the output characteristics of transistor. When collector current increases, the output voltage decreases. Means due to this, the base voltage of Q2 decreases, which is connected to the collector of the transistor Q1 in the circuit diagram. Now, as most of this collector current flows through R3, so hence we get less output voltage. In other words, the increase in voltage is offset, keeping the output voltage constant. Now let us see the case 2. Output voltage decreases. Now what happens? The output voltage tries to decrease. As a result, the feedback voltage VF decreases. Hence, the current through Q1 and R3 also reduce. So we get more base voltage at Q2 and more output voltage, consequently keeping the output voltage at its original level. Now how we calculate the output voltage? So let us see. We know the R1, R2 provides, it is the voltage divider arrangement, and it provides a feedback voltage to the transistor Q1. Now consider the feedback fraction beta, which is nothing but the ratio of feedback voltage versus output voltage. That is R2 upon R1 plus R2. Now the closed loop gain, it is denoted by ACL, which is the reciprocal of beta. So what is ACL? ACL is equal to 1 plus R2 upon R1. Now we know that VF is equal to VZ plus VBE. Now by keeping the value of VF in this equation, that is beta into Vout is equal to VZ plus VBE. Therefore, Vout is equal to VZ plus VBE upon beta. But we know that the reciprocal of beta is closed loop gain. Therefore, output voltage, it is equal to ACL into in bracket VZ plus VBE. Now, this is the output voltage. This is the equation of output voltage for transistorized regulator. Now, the main drawback of this circuit is the power dissipation in series pass transistor. Now we see the advantages and disadvantages of the transistorized regulator. Now the transistorized regulator has the output voltage remains constant in spite of change in temperature. This is the main advantage. Now the next is it has low ripple content in the DC output voltage. It has better voltage regulation than that of shunt regulator, that is Zener regulator. The output impedance is very low. It has good efficiency even for small current loads. Now the disadvantage is the series pass transistor should be power transistor and it has to be mounted on a suitable heat sink. This makes the series regulator circuit bulky and heavy. It has no so good voltage regulation of large loads currents. The transistor damage due to excessive power dissipation and it has no protection against accidental short circuit of transistor. Now the output voltage cannot be changed easily as no such means is provided. Therefore the DC output voltage is not adjustable. Means to avoid the power dissipation in the power transistor, that is series pass transistor, the external current limiting technique is used. So let us see how the technique is there. Now we see the current limiting in series regulator. If we accidentally shorts the load terminals, we get large current that will destroy the series pass transistor or other component in the circuit. Other component is Zener, nothing but Zener diode. Now the current limiting technique avoids such a damage and provides short circuit protection to the circuit. Here current limiting technique is transistor Q2 and resistor R4. The value of resistor R4 is very small, that is equal to 1 ohm. Now when the load current increases above 600 milliampere, the voltage drop across R4 also increases to more than 0.6 volt. This causes transistor Q2 to conduct through resistor R2, thereby decreasing the voltage on the base of pass transistor Q1. Now this action causes Q1 to conduct less, therefore the current cannot increase above 600 to 700 milliampere. Now when the load current is below 600 milliampere, the base to emitter voltage on Q2 is not high enough to allow Q2 to conduct. So Q2 remains in cutoff. So the circuit acts just like a series regulator. Now VBE be the base emitter voltage of transistor Q2, which is nothing but the product of short circuit current into resistor R4. So ISL be the short circuit load current, which is equal to VBE upon R4, where VBE is the base emitter voltage of Q2, that is it is the drop across the resistor R4, and R4 is the current sensing resistor.